Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends. Now we are going to do the second numerical, which is based on instantaneous rate of reaction. So before that, let us know that what is rate of reaction and what is rate of formation and what is rate of consumption. This we know already very thoroughly. But now with the help of those, we are going to solve this kind of numerical again. As on your screen, it's a question mentioned that chloroform plus Cl2 will give you CCl4 plus HCl. In this thing, we have to determine the rate of reaction along with the rate of consumption of chloroform and the rate of consumption of Cl2 if the rate of formation of HCl is given as 0.234. So how can we calculate this all three? It's very much simple. So before finding out the main content, we should know how to write the rate of a reaction for a particular reaction. And what is that? Let us see. We can calculate the rate of reaction, or we could represent the rate of reaction for a particular one by this manner. Rate is equals to, for we'll start with the reactant and we'll equate each reactant with each product. So therefore, the chloroform, which has a stoichiometry of only one, will be the reciprocal, that is one itself, but it will be in minus. Again, for the next reactant, so this was for the reactant, and now we are switching towards the product, and the product should be always positive because as the time proceeds, the concentration of product also goes on increasing. And for HCl also, it would be the same, that is, so this is how we have wrote the representation for the rate of reaction. And in this thing, we have another data, that is the rate of formation of HCl. Since the rate of formation of HCl means plus d of HCl upon dt is given as 0.234 moles per dm cube per second. And by knowing this data, we could find the rate of other reactants or rate of other products also. So for finding the first thing, that is, we could find the rate of consumption of CHCl3, that is chloroform. Since it is for consumption of CHCl3, I would write that we have to determine minus d of CHCl3 upon dt. This is what we have to calculate. So by looking at the previous data, the question which has a data is for HCl. So HCl is here, and we have to determine the rate of consumption of CHCl3. So every time we will equate this thing with this. Okay. So by knowing this values or this rate of reaction, I could equate minus d CHCl3 upon dt, which is equals to d of HCl upon dt. And the value of HCl is also given to us, or the concentration with respect to time is also given to us, and that is 0.234. And hence, the rate of consumption of the chloroform is also 0.234. But we should not forget to write the unit of it. And the unit of this will be moles per radian cube per second. So let us find out the another one, that is for Cl2. It would be the same. Again, suppose to find rate of consumption or rate of degradation or decomposition of Cl2, this is what we have to find. But we will again look at the data that we have calculated or that we have estimated, which is this. The HCl value is given to us, and we'll always equate this value with the requirement. Means always we'll equate this HCl with the Cl2 right now. So that's what we'll get. Minus D Cl2 of dt is equals to HCl upon dt. Therefore, the value of consumption of Cl2 is right now as, again, because HCl formation value, the rate of formation of HCl is given as 0.234 moles per radian cube per second. So this is how we have calculated another data. Or another requirement. And finally, we have to determine the rate of the reaction. As you know, that the whole equation has a stoichiometry of 1. So therefore, rate is equals to the value of CH3Cl that we have got, that is the rate of consumption of CHCl3, and again the rate of consumption of Cl2, and the rate of formation of HCl. So therefore, we could finally write as the rate of the reaction is 0.234 moles per dm cube per second for each reactant and for product. So I hope you have got to know how to determine this kind of values based on instantaneous rate of reaction, depending on the formation of the product or the consumption of the reactant. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this, and please don't forget to subscribe eKeeda channel and share with your friends too. Thank you so much.